His teeth, made his bed, and had a really, really good super breakfast. And now, Elmo's ready for fun. Come on!
Yay!
Elmo's ready to run, ready to play, ready to go. Elmo's up with the sun, ready to say, on with the show. Explore. If it's sunny or gray, never you mind, open up the door. There's so much to do and see, that's why Elmo's happy to be. Ready to run, ready to play, ready for fun. What do you say? Let's go!
There. Uh-oh, look.
Look what Elmo's got. It's called a growth chart. It's for measuring how tall you are.
Look, see, Elmo is this tall.
Hmm? But Elmo wonders what it feels like to be even taller.
Mark.
Oh, hi, Chicken.
Mark.
Oh, Chicken can help Elmo feel taller?
Mark.
Well, how can Chicken help? Chicken thinks Elmo looks taller now?
Mark.
Well, that's funny. Elmo doesn't feel taller.
Mark.
No, Elmo just feels like he's got a chicken on his head.
Mark.
Oh, that's okay, Chicken. You were only trying to help. But Elmo still wonders what it's like to be taller. Boy, it sounds like it might be fun.
Oh, boy, I can't wait to see.
Okay. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
There we go, take a look.
Ha, baby! I guess I'm not such a wee little bear anymore, am I?
Way to grow!
Way to grow!
Looking good! Oh, hey! Welcome to Sesame Street!
Hey!
Check it out! You know what that is?
It's a growth chart.
Oh.
Yeah, it measures how tall we are.
And it shows how much we've grown.
Yep, you're right. Now, you see that mark right there? It shows us how much Baby Bear has grown from the last time we measured and the time before that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, which one of these is Elmo's line?
Oh, buddy, this would be you right here, the red line with the E for Elmo.
Wow, mm-hmm. Elmo used to be that short.
Yeah, and look how much you've grown, buddy.
Wow, cool.
Yeah, and I was always right behind you, Elmo, every single time.
So, hey, buddy, you ready to see how tall you are now?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, all right.
Excuse me, baby.
Yeah. All right.
Okay, where?
Stand up nice and straight.
Nice and straight.
You
Elmo
ready?
Is standing up straight.
Okay, here we go. You ready?
Mm-hmm.
And, there we are.
Oh, Elmo, want to see. That's it? But that's not... That's not much taller than last time.
Well, buddy, sometimes we grow a lot, and sometimes we grow a little. Hey, Abby, your turn.
Oh, boy, I can't wait. Excuse me, Elmo. This is so great.
Okay, you ready?
All right.
Okay.
Wait.
Straighten up. There we go. Ready?
Yeah.
Actually, I'll get over here.
Uh-huh.
And there you go.
Okay.
Wow, look! I'm so much taller than last time.
You really grew, Abby.
Yeah, you're even taller than Elmo.
But Elmo's always been taller than Abby.
Oh, this must be a mistake. Abby, stand back to back to Elmo, okay?
Okay.
No tippy toes.
I won't.
Okay. What do you think now, Chris?
Let me see. It looks like Abby is taller than Elmo.
Yeah, she is. No doubt about
that. She's taller.
My mommy did say I had a growth spurt.
Oh, spurt, Abby. Yeah, growth spurt. It means you grew a lot in a little bit of time.
Elmo didn't spurt at all. And now, Elmo's the shortest.
Well, Chris hasn't measured me yet, but...
But Kelly's taller. Elmo can tell.
almost as short as...
Ah, don't worry, Elmo. Everyone grows a little differently.
But Elmo really wants to be taller.
Oh, and I know you will be. Someday.
But Chris, Elmo wants to be taller now. How can Elmo make himself taller?
Elmo, you really can't.
Well, maybe Elmo can. Be right back. Now Elmo's taller.
Whoa! Nice wig!
Thank you!
Okay, that is some seriously tall hair.
Oh, excuse me, Abby. Oh, yeah, sure. Let's see. Yeah. Oh, oh. See, it makes Elmo taller.
Okay, Elmo, having the big hair does not make you taller, buddy.
No?
Mm-mm. See, because if you remove the wig, you're still the same. Wait a minute. You're taller without the wig.
Elmo told you.
How did you do that?
What happened?
You spurted, Elmo.
No, there has to be a reason.
Don't look at Elmo's feet.
Ah, that explains it.
High heels.
Surprising, yet very stylish.
Yeah, no wonder you're taller.
Yeah, and all it took was a quick trip through Mommy's closet.
Hey, Elmo, a point for creativity, but high heels don't count either. Yeah, you're still the same height, buddy.
But Chris, Elmo really wants to be taller.
Elmo, listen to me. You're gonna grow very soon in your own time, okay? Don't rush it.
Yeah.
Hey, Telly, wanna get measured?
Oh, yeah, my turn. I almost forgot.
Step right up, buddy.
Awesome, okay, let's see. Try again. All righty.
You got it?
Elmo, are you okay?
No, Abby. Elmo doesn't want to be the shortest.
It's not so bad. I've always been the shortest, and, well, I didn't mind it.
But Elmo wants to be tall, Abby. Elmo wishes there was a way to grow fast. Hey, Abby can grant wishes, right?
Well, that is what we fairies do.
Well, okay, Abby, do a magic spell to make Elmo grow faster?
I don't know.
Oh, please, Abby. Elmo really wants to grow tall. Please.
If it's that important to you, well, then I'll give it a try.
Thank you, Abby.
Okay.
Go ahead.
All right, sure thing. I mean, what could possibly go wrong? All right. I got it. Grow. Up you go.
Check it out, Telly.
Yep, you're still the tallest.
Not anymore.
Oh, really?
Elmo grew. Measure Elmo again, Chris. Elmo's taller, right?
Oh, it's true. You did grow. I mean, no heels, no tippy toes.
Abby did a magic spell.
Abby, little girl, you got to stop doing these spells that are messing with the laws of nature.
Something always goes wrong.
But Elmo was so sad, and he really wanted to grow.
But he's only 3 1/2, and look how tall he is.
Elmo grew even taller.
That's not supposed to happen.
I got a bad feeling about this.
Here Elmo goes again. Whoa, cool. Yeah, baby.
My magic spell is out of control.
You think?
Wow, Elmo's so tall now. Oh, Elmo's even taller than the buildings.
Don't worry about it, buddy. We're gonna get you back to normal.
Yeah, I'm sure I can undo this spell.
No, but Elmo doesn't want Abby to undo it. Elmo loves being tall.
Yes, but buddy, you're just too tall.
Yeah, like way too tall.
No way. Elmo's been short all his life. Now, Elmo can finally be tall.
Elmo, hey, pal, you gotta let Abby reverse the spell, okay?
No, Elmo's putting his foot down.
Oh, Abby, you gotta reverse the spell, fast!
All right, I'm on it.
Okay.
Shrink, and awake!
What happened?
He's still gigantic!
Shrink, and awake!
Nothing!
I better call my mommy! Mommy? Yeah, Mommy? I made Elmo really tall, and now I can't get him short again. kitty, Mommy. Thanks.
Well, what does she say?
Well, she says that he's got to want to go back to his normal size.
Yeah, but how do we get him to want to be short again?
Maybe we can convince him that being enormous is not a good idea.
How do we do that?
Maybe we just need to show him all the things that he won't be able to do. Like all the things he'll miss out on by being so humongously tall.
Aha! Huh? I catch your drift, my friend. Leave it to me. Hey, everybody! Who's up for a wowsing game of jump rope?
Hey. Oh, oh, sounds like fun!
Yes, yeah. I'll play.
How about you, Elmo?
Well, sure. Elmo loves jumping rope.
Okay, great. Well, Telly and I will turn the rope, and you jump in, okay?
Okay.
Okay, here you go, Telly. You take that end.
Okay.
All righty. All right, Elmo. Jump on in anytime, buddy.
But Elmo can't. Elmo won't fit.
Well, looks like you're too tall for jump rope, buddy. Sorry.
But Elmo can still jump without a rope, like this. Jump.
No more jumping! No more jumping!
This monster is going to destroy the city.
Why do you keep doing that with your mouth?
I don't know. I saw it in a movie. Seemed like the thing to do.
There's got to be something else we can try.
Don't worry. I got an idea. Hey, how would you all like to play hide and seek?
Yeah, that works. Hey, Elmo, you want to play?
Yeah, hide and seek is Elmo's all-time favorite game.
All right, then. You all go hide and I'll seek.
Okay.
I'm going to get you. Ready? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, here I come. Oh, found you, Elmo. You're behind the table.
Oh, no fair. There was no good place for Elmo to hide.
Yep. It's got to be tough finding a hiding spot when you're that tall. I guess this isn't the game for you.
No.
But Elmo loves hide and seek. Gee, Elmo can't play hide and seek or jump rope. Elmo can't do a lot of things when he's this size.
I think he's starting to get the picture.
Yeah, and I have one more idea that just might help him decide, okay? Hey, guys, after all this excitement, I think we could use a snack, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, let's go to Hooper's.
Count me in.
Hey, Elmo, I got some nice fresh banana pudding. Come on.
Whoa, banana pudding, Elmo's favorite.
Oh, after you, Elmo.
Okay. Elmo can't. Oh, no.
What's the matter, buddy?
Elmo can't fit inside of Hooper's.
Yeah, that's true.
But Elmo loves eating in Hooper's. And if Elmo is this tall, Elmo can never eat in Hooper's again.
I guess not.
Wait, this makes Elmo really sad. Maybe Elmo's too tall.
I think you're right, buddy.
Boy, Elmo could really use a hug right now. But Elmo's too tall for that, too.
Nobody's arms can reach.
Yeah. Elmo really thought he wanted to be tall. But now, Elmo wishes he didn't want to grow at all.
But Elmo, growing taller is a part of growing up. And it's great, it just takes time. Just be patient, okay? I mean, you're gonna grow a little bit, and then a little bit, and a little bit more, and then one day, you're gonna be all grown up.
Chris, Elmo wants to go back to Elmo's normal size and wait till Elmo grows taller, but not too tall.
Oh, well, okay then, buddy. Hey, Abby! Guys, come on, Abby! Elmo wants to reverse the spell. Yeah. Come on out!
Boy.
All right!
Okay, then. Yeah. Well, it's about time.
I know.
Are you ready?
Ready, Abby.
Okay. Shrink, 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 and out. Wait! It worked! Elmo's back to normal,
Boy, it was fun being super-sized, but Elmo likes being Elmo-sized more.
Hey, how about that hug you wanted, huh?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, come here.
Yeah, Chris.
Group hug!
Boy, Elmo may be short, but he loves big hugs.
Now just stay this way, okay?
Wow, that's what Elmo calls a tall story. Oh, but Elmo's happy to be his small self again. Small is cool, too. There are lots of cool small things. Oh, look, look. A leaf is small. Boy, it has a nice wavy shape. Mm-hmm. And a leafy green color. Sweet. Oh, look at this. This is an acorn. And an acorn is even smaller than a leaf. And it looks like it's wearing a hat. Way to be fast and forward, acorn. Oh, there's a butterfly. Hi, butterfly. Wow, butterfly is small too. But you know, Elmo wonders what it's like to be a butterfly. Oh, sounds like fun to Elmo. How's it sound to you, butterfly? Oh, cool. Oh, hi. Hi, everybody.
Hey, Lucas.
Hi.
Hi, Eli.
Hi, Mr. Andre.
Hey, Elmo.
What?
Oh, look who's here.
Look. Oh, hey, welcome to Sesame Street.
We're looking at bugs.
Yeah. Oh, Elmo has his magnifying glass.
Yeah, isn't that cool?
Isn't that cool?
And I've got this great book. Fascinating Facts About Insects.
Yeah.
It's full of fascinating and interesting facts.
Yes. Oh, Kelly, let's go and see if we can find some insects.
Insects, yes.
Insects. Oh, Kelly, look.
What?
Ants.
Ants are insects.
Yeah. Oh, there's one, two little ants playing together.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Let's look at them through the magnifying glass.
Oh, okay. Here you go, Kelly.
Whoa. That magnifying glass makes them look a lot bigger.
Yeah. Oh, does Kelly's book have a fascinating fact about ants?
Well, let's see. It says here, oh, wow.
What?
Ants never sleep. Wow.
Wow.
And they don't even look tired.
Fascinating. Oh, look, more bugs, Kelly. More bugs.
What are they?
What are they?
Those are ladybugs.
Aw. One, two ladybugs playing together.
Wow.
Yeah.
Here's a fascinating fact about ladybugs.
Okay, Kelly.
They smell with their feet.
Fascinating. Oh, almost sees another bug.
Whoa.
Hey, Kelly, look. There's a butterfly.
He's beautiful.
Yeah. Wow. But where's butterfly's friend?
His friend?
Yeah. Elmo and Kelly saw two little ants and two little ladybugs, but there's only one butterfly, and it's alone.
You're right. Let's look for another butterfly.
Okay. Yoo-hoo! Other butterflies!
Hello, butterflies! Calling all butterflies!
Butterflies, where are you? Kelly, Elmo doesn't think any other butterflies are around.
Yeah, I don't think so either. Oh, no. That little guy has no butterfly friend to play with.
Oh, poor little guy.
Oh, it's terrible. Is there nothing we can do for this lonely bug?
Oh, yes. Elmo can be a butterfly.
What's that now?
Elmo will pretend to be a butterfly, Kelly. Then the little butterfly will have a friend to play with.
Great idea!
Okay, let's see. Flutter. Elmo's a butterfly. Flutter. Come play with Elmo. Oh, it's not working. The butterfly's not coming over to play.
I don't think he gets that you're a butterfly, Elmo.
Well, why not, Kelly?
I'm checking the book here. Here's something fascinating.
What?
It says here that before a butterfly can become a butterfly, it has to go through a metamorphosis.
A what?
Metamorphosis is a big change. It says here there are four very different stages in the life of a butterfly.
But Kelly, what does that have to do with Elmo?
Well, maybe if you pretend to go through those four stages, the butterfly will think that you're a butterfly and want to be your friend.
Hey, that's a great idea, Kelly. Oh, what's the first stage, huh?
First, a butterfly starts as a butterfly egg, like this.
A butterfly egg, got it. Elmo will be right back. Ta-da!
Nice egg costume, Elmo.
Well, thank you, Telly, but Elmo's not Elmo anymore. Elmo's butterfly egg Elmo.
Oh, right, right, right. And look, butterfly egg Elmo, it's working.
Oh, yay!
Yeah, yeah, the butterfly is looking right at you.
Oh, not anymore. Oh, quick, Telly, what's the second stage?
You need to pretend to be a caterpillar, like this.
A caterpillar?
Yep. The butterfly starts as an egg, and when the egg hatches, a caterpillar comes out.
Caterpillar, right. Elmo will be right back. Elmo's a caterpillar.
How did you do that?
Oh, Elmo's mommy helped.
And look, look, it's working. The butterfly is flying right to you. Is he ready to be your friend?
Oh, no, not yet. Oh, what's the third stage, Telly?
See, after the egg hatches into a caterpillar, it grows and sheds its skin, and when it does it for the last time, it forms a chrysalis.
Chris is what now?
Not Chris. Chrysalis. Like this.
Oh, it looks like a tiny sleeping bag.
Yeah, it does.
Okay, Telly, be right back. Elmo's a chrysalis.
Ooh.
Hey, look, it's working. It's working. The butterfly, it's flying all around you.
Wow, yeah. Uh-oh, but the butterfly isn't ready to be Elmo's friend yet.
That's because you need to go through the fourth stage.
Well, what's that, Telly?
That's when inside the chrysalis, the caterpillar turns into a butterfly.
Oh, Elmo thought that would come next. It's...
Wow, Elmo, you really do look like a butterfly.
Thank you, Telly.
And look, look, it's working. I think it's working. Yes, the butterfly wants to be your friend.
Hello, butterfly.
Elmo, you did it. The butterfly's not lonely anymore. He's got a new friend.
And Elmo's got a new friend, too. Come on, little butterfly. Let's be butterflies together. Oh, you too. Flap. Flutter and fly with us! Let's flap our wings and fly together, little butterfly friend. Flutter through the sky together, little butterfly friend. We can fly from here. Stop and smell a rose. We can flutter up and down. You can land on Elmo's nose. Oh, hello. Let's flap our wings and go together, little butterfly friend. Flying high and low. Little butterfly friend, as free as a breeze on a sunny day, we're butterflying all the way. Let's flap our wings and fly. Little butterfly friend.
I think your little butterfly friend is all fluttered out, Elmo.
Yeah, Elmo too. Yeah. Oh, maybe we need a butterfly snack.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, little butterfly friend. Come on, Telly. Come on.
Hey, guys. Hey,
hey Chris.
Hey,
Chris.
Hey, Chris.
Hey, Telly.
Hi.
Elmo?
No, butterfly.
You noticed.
This is oh. Elmo's butterfly friend. Ooh. Say hello to Chris, butterfly.
Oh, hello. Hey, hey. Did he just land on my head?
Yep.
Oh, okay. What can I do for you guys?
Well, Elmo and his butterfly friend are hungry. Oh, does Chris have any butterfly food, please?
Wow, that's a new one. I honestly have no idea what butterflies eat.
Ah, well, it says right here that they don't eat.
How's that?
It's a fascinating fact. Butterflies don't eat, they drink.
What do they drink, Telly?
They usually drink nectar from flowers, but they can also drink the juice from a fruit.
Oh, you like fruit juice, butterfly? Oh, guess what? Elmo likes fruit juice, too. Elmo and his butterfly friend have a lot in common.
Hey, Elmo, you are in luck because I just so happen to have these delicious orange slices for you and your buddy. Let's see if your little butterfly friend likes
that. Can Elmo have one?
There you go.
Thank you. He's drinking.
Look at that.
And he's using his proboscis.
What is?
Proboscis. It's a curly little thingy that unrolls and becomes like a straw that he drinks through.
Fascinating.
Oh, drink up, little butterfly friend. Oh, Elmo would drink up too. Oh, thanks for the oranges, Chris.
You're welcome, Elmo.
Now, what are you and your butterfly friend gonna do?
Well, now, Butterfly Elmo wants to draw a picture of his butterfly friend.
Oh, hey. Huh? I have just the thing. I have some paper and some crayons, eh?
Oh, good.
There you go, buddy.
Boy, Chris has everything today.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, Chris.
Mm-hmm. No
problem. Come on, Telly. Let's go. Oh, you too, butterfly friend.
Hey, Elmo.
Huh?
The book says that's a monarch butterfly.
Wow, a monarch?
Yeah. That's what you call a butterfly with orange wings with black lines and white spots. Monarch butterflies.
Cool. We're almost best friends with a monarch butterfly. Oh, look.
Hey, Elmo.
Huh?
I think he liked your picture.
Oh, yeah. Yay, little butterfly friend. Oh, you are the most special butterfly in the whole world. Elmo bets there is no other butterfly quite like you.
Except maybe that one.
Hey, it's another monarch!
And that one! And that one! And that one! And that one!
I wonder what's going on here.
Well, maybe Elmo's butterfly friend is having a butterfly party. Yay!
I don't think so, Elmo.
Well, then why are those little butterflies here?
It says here that monarch butterflies get together to migrate.
Migrate? What's that?
Migrate means they move because of the change in seasons. Yeah, it's just too cold here in the winter.
Whoa, there they go.
But Elmo's butterfly friend wouldn't leave Elmo. We're best friends, right, butterfly friend? Oh, no, but... Oh, that was Elmo's butterfly friend. No.
I'm sorry, buddy.
But he didn't even say goodbye. He forgot all about Elmo.
Maybe not. Look, he came back to say goodbye to you.
Wow!
Goodbye, little butterfly friend. And don't worry, Elmo understands. Elmo, we'll always have this picture to remember you by.
What?
Goodbye, little butterfly friend. Well, guess Elmo better take off his butterfly costume.
No. Wait, don't, Elmo.
Well, why not, Telly?
Because now I want a butterfly friend.
You do? Well, come on, friend. Let's find out more fascinating facts about bugs.
All right. Okay, listen to this.
Yeah?
Dragonflies are the fastest flying bugs of all. And they can eat while flying.
Really cool.
Fascinating.
Boy, Elmo had fun being a butterfly. What can Elmo do next?
Hey, you want to try being a chef?
A chef? Well, what do chefs do?
Oh, chefs make delicious things to eat.
Oh, yum, like what?
Oh, different chefs make different things. I'm a pizza chef, so I make a pizza.
Wow, Elmo loves pizza. How does Mr. Chef make it?
First, I toss it a pizza dough.
You what?
I toss it a pizza dough.
You toss it a pizza dough.
Yeah, that's how you make it the crust.
Oh, good.
You toss it a pizza dough.
You toss it a pizza dough.
Right like this.
Okay.
The dough goes up and down. The dough goes up and down.
Oh.
The dough goes up and down. The dough goes
up
and down. It's all in the wrist, Elmo. You want to try?
Oh, yeah, Elmo would love to.
Here you go. Now toss it a pizza dough.
Toss it a pizza dough.
Okay. Yes.
The pizza dough goes up.
Oh.
Hey.
Oh, well, it's a way up.
Well, where'd you go?
Oh, boy.
Hey, where you go?
Hey, you caught it. Good catch, Elmo.
Oh, sorry, Chef.
Oh, no. That's okay. It takes a practice to be a chef. You can start by being a chef's assistant.
A chef's assistant? Well, that sounds like fun.
That's it, Elmo. One lunch to go.
Oh, good!
Oh, hey, welcome to Sesame Street.
Alan, what's with the lights?
And the funny music!
I don't know.
Alan of Hooper Store!
Congratulations! You've been selected as our next challenger on... Cast Iron Cook!
Cast Iron what?
Cast Iron Cook! It's the best show on TV!
Indeed it is! Cast Iron Cook, where every week an amateur chef pits his cooking skills against the skills of my three prize-winning... Cast Iron Cooks! Behold, my Cast Iron Cooks!
Stuff get here.
That's the magic of television, Alan.
Ha ha! Welcome to Cast Iron Cook.
Who's that guy?
That's Super Chef Elmo. He's the host and the judge.
Alan of Hooper Store, are you ready to test your cooking skills against the Cast Iron Cooks?
No.
What?
No? Come on, Alan. You're the best cook on Sesame Street. You could beat these guys.
Chris is right. Alan's the
Yeah.
Alan of Hooper Store, who have you chosen to assist you today?
What, assist me? I haven't even...
Very well, then. Today's challenge. You and your assistants will do battle with the Cast Iron Cooks in the preparation of three dishes. Cast Iron Cooks, are you ready?
Ready!
Alan of Hooper Store and your assistants, are you ready?
Ready.
Very well, then. Competition number one. You must each prepare a unique and delicious bowl of pea stew.
Pea stew? Don't you mean pea soup?
No, misguided assistant. I mean pea stew. A stew made up entirely of ingredients, which start with the letter P. And you must do it before time runs out. Begin!
P!
Peaches!
Good one!
Yeah!
Pickles!
Pickles!
Yeah! Cool!
Pineapple! Okay, I got pineapple!
Good! Help Chris and Al cooking!
Peppers!
Peppers! Got them! Peppers right here!
Yeah!
Peanuts!
Peanuts!
Oh, goodness! Popcorn!
Popcorn! Look at that!
Time's almost up, and although you've acquired a variety of intriguing ingredients, they don't look much like a stew.
Oh, he's right. Yeah. We need the glue that holds this stew together.
Glue? That doesn't start with P.
No. But porridge does.
Oh,
porridge!
Yeah,
right, that's
it! Put it in!
Time's up! Let's begin with our challengers and see how they did. Peaches, pickles, pineapple, peppers, popcorn, and peanuts, all in a porridge base, yes. Definitely ingredients that all start with the letter P. Mm-hmm. Now for the taste. Putrid.
What?
Which, by the way, starts with the letter P.
Oh. Oh, no.
Oh, man.
And now, for my cast iron cooks. Plums, plantains, pears, and pomegranates in a blended papaya base. All fruits that start with the letter P. Ingenious. And the flavor? Superb. Which means the clear winner of the first competition is...
Wait a minute! What's this?
It's a hat! Ah, good job!
I can only guess that this hat must have fallen in the pot by accident, because the word hat starts with the letter H, not with the letter P.
Yeah, well, however it got in there, it was in there, which means they didn't make a P stew, they made a P and H stew.
Unfortunately correct, which means round one, worth 1 point, improbably goes to... Alan from Hooper's store!
Yes! Wow! Alan, you're really into this, huh?
Are you kidding? We won the first round! We could win this whole thing!
Yeah!
Competition number two! You must each prepare a unique and delectable apple pie.
Yes! Oh. I'm so good at apple pie. Alan makes a delicious apple pie.
Well, actually, my apple pie is pretty good.
An apple pie, which must be made of exactly 8 apples. No more. No less.
Ooh, 8 apples? Ooh, does Alan have 8 apples?
I don't think I do.
And you must do so before time runs out. Begin!
1, 2, 3.
Okay, I know I have apples somewhere in the store.
Where, Alan?
I got it!
Okay. Oh, good remembering, Alan.
Thanks.
Let's see how many we got. We got one.
One.
We got two. We have three.
Four.
Oh, four is less than 8, Alan.
All right, hang on. I know I have some more.
Six.
Seven.
They're almost at 8.
Yes.
Got it.
Here. Okay.
Oh, good. All right. Well, we have 4.
All right. That makes 5. Now we have 6.
7.
Oh, we still don't have 8 apples.
I'm sorry. I think that's all I've got.
Oh. 8. Time to bake a pie, cooks.
They have all their apples! What are we gonna do?
Wait. Alan, remember when Alan made Elmo's lunch?
Elmo's lunch,
yeah.
Yes, but... Elmo's lunch, that's
yeah,
it!
Yeah.
Hey! Okay, well, we had 7, uh-huh. So we had 1, so now we have 8 apples all together!
Now all we have time to do is put them in the pie crust, sprinkle sugar and cinnamon over them, and get them in the oven.
Okay.
Go.
Crisp.
Now, Elmo, not now.
What? Elmo, just put cinnamon and sugar on top of the pie.
Oh no!
Time's up. Once again, we begin with our challenger, Alan of Hooper's store. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Mm-hmm. Surprisingly, the correct number of apples. And now the taste test. Pepper in an apple pie? Revolting.
Sorry.
And now, my cast iron cooks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. As I expected, the precise number of apples. And now, the taste. Incomparable. Which means that the undisputed winner of the second competition is...
Wait a minute. What's this?
Glasses? Ah, can't you keep anything on?
The recipe called for 8 apples, not 8 apples and a pair of glasses.
Unfortunately, the annoying but perceptive assistant is once again correct, which means that the winner of round number 2, worth 1 point, is Alan of Hooper's store.
mean, we already scored 2 points. That means even if we lose the next one, we still win the game!
Actually, I'm afraid you won't.
We won't? Well, why not? Yeah.
Because unlike the other rounds, the third and final round is worth not one, but 3 points.
Oh. 3 points? How is that fair? No, come on! It should be 1 point like that!
Competition number three! Woo! You must each prepare a unique and delicious Hafgarian goulash. Oh.
Hafgarian goulash? What's Hafgarian goulash?
A traditional dish prepared for centuries by Hungary's finest mathematicians. Your goulash may be made up of any ingredient you choose, but they must be cut precisely in half.
Cut precisely in half?
Man, that is one weird dish.
Indeed. But you must still prepare it perfectly before time runs out.
Begin!
Okay, we have to cut things in half, but what things?
Well, at least he did say we could use any ingredients we wanted to, right?
Ooh, true. Elephant, oh. Something.
A cantaloupe. That's perfect, Elmo. All right, I'm gonna start cutting. You guys keep looking.
All right? Elmo has a question.
Sure, Elmo, but can you make it quick?
Okay, well, what does it mean to cut something in half?
Oh, okay. Well, take this cantaloupe, right?
Yeah.
It's whole. Uh-huh. But if I cut it into 2 pieces,
okay,
like this, right? And those 2 pieces are exactly the same size, then each of them is called a half. Got it?
Got it.
All right, then let's get to it. Right.
Put it in the top. All
right. And cut.
One celery.
One celery.
Yeah.
Cut
in half.
I just wanted to make sure that you hadn't cut your glasses in half.
Elmo has a salami.
One salami.
Right.
Cut
in half.
In half. Yes.
Put it in the top.
Hey, hey.
What?
One eggplant.
Ah. One eggplant.
Yeah.
Cut
in
half.
Yes.
Put it in the top.
And so now it has come down to this, the third and final competition. Let's begin again with our challenger, Alan of Hooper Store. Eggplant, cantaloupe, celery, and salami. Each of them cut exactly in half. But now for the all-important taste test.
Super Chef didn't say it was putrid or disgusting this time. He must have liked it.
And now, to see what wonder my cast iron cooks have wrought. Potatoes, parsnips, turnips, carrots, and 3 different kinds of peppers, each of them cut in half with surgical precision. Brilliant work. Now for the taste. Yeah. Spectacular! Yes! Which means that with 3 points in the final round, the winner, to no one's surprise, is...
Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Look at that!
A wristwatch!
Really?
But most importantly, a wristwatch which is not cut in half.
Well, you can't win them all, right? And so, you have 2 points. Add 3 more. Now you have 5 points, which means the winner of today's cast iron cook is Alan of Hooper Store.
Alan and his assistants.
Yeah.
Tune in next time when the cast iron cooks, and possibly a new one, do battle against another courageous challenger. Until then, cook well. And prosper! My belt! Who cut my belt in half? Guys!
Hey, good job, buddy.
Cool, cool, cool. Oh, Elmo did so many really cool things today. Like measuring on a growth chart. Oh, helping a chef. Singing to a butterfly. And Elmo had fun doing them all. That's because there's a lot of different ways you can have fun. Come on!
Ask him if a brand new friend can come and play.
splashing in your boots on a rainy day. Thinking that it might be time to try ballet. It's all kinds of fun. Following an ant just to see where he goes. Feeling summer grass right between your toes. Balancing a beach ball on your nose. It's all kinds of fun. It's all kinds of fun. All the little things turn into big happenings. All kinds of fun. Spin his own cocoon. Wonder what it's like dancing on the moon. Paint a pretty picture of a red balloon. It's all kinds of fun. Listen to a rooster cock a doodle-doo. Play a silly song on your own kazoo. Reach up to the sky and shout, yeah, baby!